Hey, hey, everybody. Good morning and good afternoon if you're over on the East Coast. This is the Moms Making Money Show. I'm Amie Pederson, and I have an awesome guest today. I have Jamie Palmer here. She's over on the East Coast, and we were just comparing life notes and giggling about how similar our life situations actually are. And she's going to share some pretty cool stuff with us about her journey and some of the things that she's overcome in life, and give us a little tidbit about her business and some information and probably some good takeaways. So if you guys are popping on live, make sure that you ask your questions. And if you're catching the replay, just type in replay. Let us know that you were here. We've got the little guy here today. There's a good chance my other little guy may pop in here at any time if he wakes up. But I'm going to turn it over to Jamie and have you just tell us a little bit about your amazing story and how you got started as an entrepreneur.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here. So I actually started my business journey in college, which was almost 15 years ago now, which is crazy to think about. But I started my business in college. I was going to school for accounting, and I could not find a job that I loved. I was actually working at my aunt's embroidery factory at the time, like kind of helping out in the office and doing lots of organizational stuff. So I was in that entrepreneurial zone. And I just kind of said, you know what, let me give it a try. And I talked to my dad about it, and I was like, hey, I'm going to go start my own business and yada yada. And he was like, you're crazy. But if you're going to do it, now's the time to do it because you don't have a lot to lose. And so I started my business in college, and it's been a wild ride ever since. And it's crazy because when you start your business, like, it's not always what it ends up to be later on. So originally we had like a web design business, and that was the only thing that we offered. And I got to, you know, I was always networking and doing all these kind of like crazy things. And like, I work at night and I'd network during the day because I had all this free time. I didn't have kids then. I had so much free time.
It didn't probably seem like a ton of free time back then.
It didn't. But it's funny, social media kind of came out, and when I was networking, I would always use social media to stay in touch with the people that I had met. And back before they had like pages, like business pages. That's how long ago this was. And that's, you know, we added that service, and, you know, it's been a crazy journey because it's like everything's always changing and evolving, and it's a lot of fun. I love what I do. It's so fun.
It is fun. And it's super funny because it's like you said, like you get to like stay in touch with everybody, like through social media. It's like a great tool. And you're keeping in touch with them without actually keeping in touch with them. Like, you don't have to pick up the phone and call them. You don't have to send a letter. Like, you know what they're doing. You know what they've got going on. You know how life is with, you know, just by following along in their journey and vice versa. So it's kind of a neat tool in that way.
Yeah.
I think anyways.
I would agree completely.
Oh, you think it's funny too? We might have some serious entertainment here today. Never know. Be warned, everybody. Be warned. sorry, my voice is still a little raspy. I completely lost my voice earlier this week, but it's finally coming back. And I'm like, oh my goodness. I was actually out of town the other day for the day, for like a VIP type of day. And my voice was totally gone. So I was like, I could barely like talk to the other ladies or anything. Was craziness. But so after the social media like evolution started, and what was it that made you like really decide like, okay, I'm gonna start? Because I think a lot of people are afraid to evolve their businesses, you know, like I feel like if they think like I've been told I have to be in like a certain niche, and if I expand or if I evolve, then I'm going to lose all my customers and nobody's going to come to me. And, you know, they feel like that's a really scary thing. And I feel like it's a really normal thing to evolve in your business.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and it's I think it's totally normal too. I think it can feel uncomfortable to do it. Like, we even went through another evolution last year where we went from doing we've gone through several evolutions. We went from like really only working with people locally to After my first son was born in 2013, I was like, I'm not running around like a crazy person, like driving to appointments and doing all this sort of stuff. And then we evolved to being like totally just online, working with other online entrepreneurs. And then last year we added in this whole teaching component where we teach people how to do this stuff as well. And, you know, it's one of those things where we as human beings evolve, like we grow, we change, we, you know, expand our knowledge and who we are as people. And so, you know, a business is a living, breathing thing, right? Or even if it's just a personal brand, it's still a you know, even if you're just the only person in your business, it's still a living, breathing thing. And as you grow, or in my opinion, as you grow as an entrepreneur, you can also change and have different opinions about, like, when I first started my business, we worked generally with only men. Like, it was just kind of how it worked. And now it's 95% female, and I wouldn't have it any other way, you know? And it's totally, you have to embrace that change. It can be challenging and scary. I remember the first time, like when we really switched from going from being in person all the time to online. And I was like, oh my goodness, it was so scary. I was so resistant to it. I thought like all my current customers were just going to leave me because I wasn't going to like drive to their location anymore. And it was actually really good. It was so much healthier for everybody. Like, I wasn't spending days in the car. Like, I could actually get stuff done and respond faster. And it made like my customer service better, right, as a result of it. And I think it's important to embrace those changes. It's just like anything else in life.
And they even probably at first, they were probably like, wait, what? Jamie's not going to come here anymore. And then they were probably like, oh, this is so much easier. We just pop online. And then when we're done, she's gone. And for them, I think it, you know, at first it might've even been a little bit like, how's this going to work? And then they see, oh, this is really seamless. This is really awesome. Like, cool. Okay.
Yeah.
And then be like, oh, well, in case I'm not at the office that day, I can still meet up with her virtually and I can still get the information I need and we can still get those tasks accomplished. So I think that at first, like, you know, especially like you think about going back to like a little bit old school.
Yeah.
It's still nice to have in-person time with each other. You know, like that's what I've found lately, that I really love having like retreats and VIP days, because that in-person time is still amazing.
Yeah.
But to be able to still just get business done, you know, real like seamlessly and streamlined, this online thing is incredible for that.
Right. Well, and like as a mom, right? Like I don't know about you. I'm not going to speak for you, but I'll speak for me. I want to be able to, like, my kid who's on the monitor sleeping in the other room, right? Or I think he's sleeping. And I can be here and be present with him and not have to worry about handing him off to a sitter or whatever. And, you know, that's part of the reason why I started this business in the first place, because I wanted to be able to have freedom over what I was going to do, when I was going to do it, how I was going to do it, and be able to create that structure to be, you know, it's become much more driven around being a present parent as I became a mom. But I mean, it was all about freedom in the beginning.
Right. And then when you decide like, okay, today I want to have a break. So here, honey, you get to watch the kids. I'm going to get my toenails done. Like, okay. But that's like something you get to choose like in that moment. Or if you're like, okay, we're just going to go to the beach today, or we're just going to go do this today. Hi, Carrie. Feel free to ask any questions while you're hopped on. That's like the coolest thing. Like, I always tell a story, and I know Carrie can relate to this. She was on the phone with me one time, and I took her to the beach with me. Like, you know, I was just like, hey. And that's kind of the cool thing. Like, when you have like a 9-to-5 job, the idea of like going to the beach while you're quote unquote working is not usually something that comes up as not even acceptable, but doable. You know, and then you have like, so for you, I know like having that freedom to be there with your kids and be present, that's obviously like 100% me. But like, I think about all the times, like, cause when my oldest son Easton was born, I went back to work, and, you know, because I just, that was who I was. That was my identity. That's what I did. That was, you know, like, how could I walk away from a paycheck and all, you know, all these things. Like, I had, you know, quote unquote, such a good job, and which it was a great job. But like, even if you had to ask for a day off, like I did a podcast interview the other day, and she was like, so you're kind of the odd one where you actually liked your job. She's like, but what about like sick days and stuff like with your kids? I was like, yeah, I went to work sick because I saved my sick days for when my kids were sick, you know? And like, that's, I think, super common for almost every mom out there that, you know, they will muster through it. And, you know, I think, well, moms, even if you're a work at home or stay at home mom, you have to muster through being sick anyways, because you don't get a sick day from these guys. Yeah. But even still, it's like, then you're like, oh my gosh, like, I've used all my sick days, but my kid's still sick. Like, now what? Now what? But when you're out there and you're doing your own thing, you don't actually have to worry about that. You're like, hey, client, like, you know, I have to take my kid to the doctor because he's sick. Can we please reschedule? And like, for me, and probably maybe the same for you, if that hasn't happened to me yet, but if it ever did, like, most of my clients are moms. So they get it. They're like, oh yeah, hopefully, you know, they'll be like, which kid is it? Well, you know, hopefully they're okay. And, you know, put me in for next Tuesday instead, you know? So that's really cool, because I don't think every boss out there or every manager or even your coworkers, I don't think they're that understanding. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'd agree with that. And I have been there. I have like had to be like, I have to cancel this because I have to take my kid out to the doctor. And exactly like you said, my client was like, so cute. My client was exactly that. Oh, ironically enough, is Easton okay? you know, and they know the kids by first name. They see them, you know, not that they have a relationship with them, but they know who they are and they relate to you in a different way. And so, yeah, it just gives you so much freedom for sure.
Mm-hmm. And less guilt about it, right? Like, because you know that your clients are understanding, you know that they're like, oh my gosh, like, is, so you guys, funny enough, both of us have sons that are exactly the same age, and both of us have sons whose names are Easton. So if you're getting confused, that's where we're both coming from. but yeah, like, most of the people who I work with one-on-one, they end up being like your personal friends, because you get to know each other so much. And depending on what you're working on, you know, it can be, you know, pretty personal things that you work through. And so becoming friends is just like a natural part of the process, I think. And I think that's one of the best benefits, because I love some of these girls that I work with. Like, you know, like when it's like time to, like, you know, when the time is up, I'm kind of like, oh, like, I want to stay with you. Don't break up with me. Like, you know, more so than like outside of like the whole business side of things. You're like, oh, okay. You know, like, stay with me, because I like seeing, you know, for me, even when I did health coaching, for me, I loved seeing people's evolution. I loved seeing their transformations. Yeah. And the same is true for my ladies who are starting businesses. I love watching them like grow and flourish and like thrive. I'm sure you can relate to that.
Totally. And I think one of the biggest things too is that's part of the beauty of working for yourself, right? And that's part of, like, it's also part of the struggle when you first get started too, right? Like, I feel like for me, one of the things that was definitely a challenge over time was, like, I kept working with these clients and never felt super good. And I think that's part of the evolution. Like, how do you go from, like, working with anybody who would say yes to you? Because that's what you want to do when you first get into business, and then figuring out who is that ideal person that you love working with and you show up for.
Exactly. I've got both of my kids in here now. Yeah, no, and it's so true. It's so true, because the relationships are real relationships that you're developing with each other. And you just can't help but like getting to know each other and, you know, liking each other and becoming friends. And I think that's a really cool thing. And it doesn't matter if you're part of like MLM or what your business is. And I think that's one thing that probably is so attractive about MLMs is as soon as you join an MLM, you're instantly part of a team.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, for sure. And you're instantly part of a support group and people, you know, lifting you up and showing you the way. And I think that's super cool, because I often talk about this, like in some of my trainings and stuff, you don't have that kind of like love and support when you join another office full of women. It's usually like, you know, like all the
yes,
so office politics and drama and gossip and everything else. But that's not the case in the online space. I'm not saying there's not ever any drama with MLMs or online businesses or anything like that. But it's so different. Like, just the whole atmosphere is so different.
Yeah, agreed. I totally agreed. And I think, you know, it's also just much more collaborative, right? Mm-hmm. And And honestly, that was very much one of those things why I made a very intentional shift to work online and work with women, because most of the women that I work with in the online space are all like, we're cheering each other on, right? Like, I mean, like, let's see how successful this person can be versus like trying to, you know, tear each other down or not be like supportive of one another, you know?
Right, right. Exactly. And that's not the way, like most workplaces are or ever have been. You know, it's always like cutthroat, and I'm afraid to like train this person to take my spot while I just go on vacation. Or so then you're like, I'll just work while I'm on vacation. I'll just bring my computer. That's what I used to do. Like, I'll just bring my computer. And not so much because I was worried somebody was going to take my job. I was just like, it's just easier for me to just do it myself, you know? And now I'm kind of like, if I'm going to go on vacation, like I'll do this, this, and this while I'm there because I want to, not because it has to get done. Yeah. You know, that's the other cool thing is a lot of times we forget that working on in an online space, you get to do a lot of things that you can like automate. Like you can pre-schedule an email, you can do different things, you can do, and you know, you still have a functioning business maybe while you're, you know, having that laptop lifestyle, sitting on the beach, you know, checking your social media, drinking a Mai Tai or something in Hawaii or whatever.
For sure. Yeah. I mean, that's the biggest thing. Automate as much as you can too, right? Like, I mean, that's one of the things that we often do for clients. We're like, all right, social, 30 days of social media done, right? Like all you have to do is like, make sure nobody needs you. So, and I think that's also the beauty of like 2018 and being in business for yourself. Like you can get all of that stuff scheduled. You can disappear for a week and not have your business fall apart. Like you can come to a whole bunch of leads and, you know, all of this positivity.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. Julie has a comment here. She says, it's so touching. You are so real. You deal with the same stuff we all do. And then she has another appointment, kids or another comment, kids, appointments, etc. Yeah, we do. We're, you know, I mean, you probably still get up and schedule in your kids' doctor's appointments around, you know, your work schedule, or probably vice versa, schedule your work schedule around your kids' doctor's appointments. And that works, you know, that works for so many moms who work from home, you know, but they're still able to provide, they're still able to have something else going on besides just being a mom. You know what I mean? And not to say that just being a mom, that there's anything wrong with that, but I feel like, you know, a lot of women are in the situation where they have to work. So being able to have that balance of both and not have to decide, I think that is awesome. Or even just being able to decide like, yeah, I want to earn a little bit of extra money, whether it's from a need base or just a want base. Like, yeah, I want to earn a little bit of extra money so that I can take my kids to Disneyland, or so I can do this, or, you know, something little, you know, even as small as like, I just want to get my toenails painted or whatever, you know, like, I think that's so awesome.
Yeah, that being able to contribute, I think, is so, I know for me, I took 3 months off after my first son was born, and I was like, by the time the 3 months was over, I was not only bored, but I just felt like I wanted to give, like, contribute to the family.
Yeah, yeah, and I think, I don't know, like, where in society, like, that shifted, but I feel like that's very common, like, because I'm exactly the same, like, I wanted to always, like, growing up, you know, we didn't grow up with a ton of money or anything, so I always wanted to be in the position where it's like, I always want to be able to know that I can take care of myself. I always want to be in the position to know that I can earn an income and earn a living and, you know, like, and not feel like I'm dependent on like my husband or whatever. Yeah. And so that was always really important for me to be able to say like, yeah, I'm earning money. Yes, I'm contributing. So being able to do that, like at an, you know, up leveling that to making it my own business, that's extra cool to me.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But you know what? I love that you said that too about like, it doesn't matter whether you want to just make a little to contribute or you want to make a lot. Like that's, you can do either. Right. And you can define what you want to do too. You can be like, hey, I only want to work Monday, Wednesday, Thursday, or whatever it is. And it's, you know, so long as you set the expectation with clients that that's what's going on. Like, I haven't had any clients that have like been like, no, Jane, that's not going to work.
Yeah. Right. All right. We've got another comment here. It's nice to be part of something where it's so open, like, yeah, my kids are here. This is my life. So transparent. It is inspiring that you are showing us the real you. Most don't. Yeah, I don't really, and probably Jamie can relate. We don't really know any other way at this point to be than just who we are. But having this, you know, being our own boss gives us that freedom. We don't have to try to act more professional than we want to or than we are. We don't have to do, you know, we don't have to do anything that we don't want to do. You know, like, I don't have to have my kid in this video. It's just how my life is today. And it's probably how my life will be next week. But that's okay.
Yeah. And to that point, though, right? Like, that's part of the reason why we work for ourselves. But B, it's like, every day isn't going to be perfect. Like, I went on a rant about this the other day, because it was so frustrating. Like, I'm so sick of seeing everyone's like perfectly curated Instagram feeds. Like, it's not real, people. Like, it's just not how real life is. Like,
yeah.
Last week I cried. I don't often cry in business, but last week I cried. I was so frustrated. Like, it happens. Everything isn't perfect. And like, I shared that experience and it made people feel like, oh my goodness, like, Jamie cries too. Like,
yeah, she's a human. She's not like just a highlight reel.
Right. Right. And I think that's the thing. I think it's so important, especially for moms, to share that authentic self and to share the behind the scenes and to be real and have kids on calls and, because all that happens.
And the good thing, and you know, maybe it's because like most of my clients are moms, but like if one of my clients has a kid and their kid starts squawking in the background, whether it's crying or laughing or running around or screaming even, it doesn't bother me. Like, I'm not put off by that. I'm just like, oh, do you want me to hold on for a second so you can take care of that? Or you know, she'll be, you know, maybe if she's like me sometimes, like, oh no, she's just, you know,
yeah,
having a moment, we can go on, like, okay, cool. Like, here we go. Like, cause I'm not bothered by it. Cause you know, like, maybe I'm like desensitized. I don't know.
I know I am, for sure. I'm like, yep, doesn't bother me.
Yeah. And it doesn't bother me at all. You like
notice.
Yeah. One girl's like, oh, well, I'll try to, you know, see if I can get a babysitter while my kids or for my kids while we do our calls. The other one, like, eh, you don't have to do all that. I don't care. Like, if your kids are in the background, you know, if that's what you need to focus, that's fine. But don't do it on my behalf at all.
Yeah, exactly. That's too funny. It's so true too, right? Like, you don't have, like, and that's, but that's, society tells us like, oh, you should have a sitter for the kid because the kid can't whatever. And it's not the way that it has to be at all.
Yeah. The funny thing is I think that people think that sometimes winging it in business and winging it in life is unusual, like that online entrepreneurs are the only ones that do that. I guarantee that a lot of the, you know, corporate men and women out there at executive levels, you know, like even like having come from an executive position, I still had a boss. I guarantee there were certain things that he would just wing it, you know, like he didn't have a plan on every single thing and every single aspect of life and business and everything else. So I feel like you were saying, like you get like the highlight reels, you get everything is perfect. That's because in corporate, you're not privy to all the decision making. You're not privy to all of the chaos that goes on behind the scenes at that higher level. You just know what you're told and you know what I mean? And most bosses don't come out like a frazzled wreck and like, oh my God, happened today, they don't even tell you. Yeah. So I think that some of that is lost in the workplace too, because you just aren't, you're not able to see that. Whereas yeah, people like us, we share it online, you know, we're like, got our kids on here. And at any, it was super funny, he just needs, I was gonna say, at any minute there could be boogers, you know? So, I mean, I think it's just different because when you have like a lifestyle brand or a personal brand, that's how people do relate to you over a corporation that's just a company, you know what I mean? Or just a logo to them. So that's what I think is kind of cool. I wanted to go over too with you a little bit. Tell me about like when you first got started, you know, maybe it's like during your evolution or like when you started just out of college, what kind of obstacles did you face? Like, did you have self-doubt? Was there fear? Was there, you know, people on the outside saying like, hey, you can't do this or you're crazy or, you know?
Yeah. My My family was for sure not always the most supportive. They still sometimes are a little crazy about it, which is silly. Like, we've been in business for 15 years. I have a team of five. Like, we're not going anywhere. Yeah. Sometimes my dad's still like, are you sure you don't want to go get a regular job? I'm like, no.
I'm 100% sure of that.
I'm 100% sure of that. I would say getting people to buy into the vision who aren't, or who don't necessarily understand why you're doing it and the impact that you want to make. And even if you do share that with them, they're just so, I want to say, like, they have their blinders on to what they see as the quote unquote right thing to do. I think that was definitely a challenge. And for sure, I think, you know, definitely during my evolution, I think money mindset was actually a really big thing too. But you know, overcoming that is, like, to me, overcoming, especially the family support stuff, has happened over time by showing success and showing growing the company and showing growing the impact. And, it was one of those things where I just stopped sharing, right? I just stopped, and that's not always necessarily the right thing to do, but I stopped talking to those people about it and found other support in fellow entrepreneurs to help kind of push me along, who understood the impact, who understood the vision, who, you know, wanted to support. And now today it's so different. Like, you know, we threw a big party at the end of the year last year where I invited my entire family because it was our best year ever, right? Like, last year we doubled the business and we threw a big party over it. And so that was, like, a really big thing. And it takes time, because especially people who come from a corporate background aren't going to necessarily understand, like, why you'd give up a perfectly good job to start from zero, right?
Right. Yeah, I heard that a lot. Like, you're going to leave your job. You have such a good job. I'm like, yeah, I know. But yeah, I'm going to leave it because I had, like, and I wasn't, you know, I used to always say, like, I'm not sure exactly what I want to be when I grow up. I finally figured that out, like, over the last, like, 9 months. Like, I finally know what I want to be when I grow up. And, you know, this is it. Like, I want to make an impact in a big way. But by working for somebody else, that was never going to be possible. Like, yeah, I did charity work. And I sat on, like, the board for, you know, the American Lung Association, like, locally here for a couple years, and helped them with, you know, putting together their charitable events and stuff. But I, you know, that was still limited too. You know what I mean? Like, so it's just like, I just want to do my own thing. I just want to do it how I want to, when I want to, like, you know.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. That's good. I'm glad that you guys are having so much success. So that way, like, one day you have kind of that, like, see, I told you I could do it, you know, and then get that kind of, not like an I told you so thing, but like, yes, I did it, even though there were so many people out there who didn't understand, who didn't think it was possible, who thought that I needed to take another path. And there's just some, I don't know, there's something kind of gratifying about that, in my opinion. Yeah. Just to overcome the odds. And it's neat because, like, I feel like women who do, like, what we do, it's part of I feel like we're part of a revolution. I feel like the way that women work is starting to shift in such a huge way. And you've probably seen this huge, right? Since you've been doing it for the last 15 years, how women are showing up in the workplace and how the impact is on their incomes and their family and their confidence in every way of showing up as a business owner and not just a secretary or an assistant.
Yeah, it's amazing thing too. It was a struggle for me for a long time too, like, around my worth and my confidence around my worth, right? And
right.
I hired a coach like you, right, to help me feel better about that and help me revamp my money mindset and help me get to that next level.
Mm-hmm. He says, yes, busting through the box and breaking the mold. Yeah, exactly. And, you know, it's not an overnight thing, but I love seeing, you know, how women like us are doing our own things, and women who are joining MLMs are taking that chance and believing in themselves, even though I'm sure they still have plenty of self-doubt, because that's just natural. You know, the money mindset stuff, the self-doubt, all that stuff creeps in from time to time. But the cool thing is you get to learn how to change your self-talk and how you can, like, more quickly, like, snap yourself out of it. and overcome some of those obstacles. And I think that's really cool. But there, you know, you have to have a vision. You have to at least have something that is like, okay, I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do. Like for me, like, I don't know what I'm going to be when I grow up. It took me till I was 35 to figure it out. But you have to have like a spark or an idea or something inside that's like, okay, I'm going to do something, whether you know what it is exactly or not. That's okay. It'll evolve. You'll figure it out. Because I feel like most of us are multi-passionate anyways, right? So
I would say start by starting.
Right, right. And the cool thing is, it's like, even if something doesn't go quite right, you're not going to get in trouble. You're not going to get fired. Nothing bad is going to happen, except that you're going to have a lesson to take away from whatever you tried that didn't work out. So it's not even a failure. It's not even failing forward per se. I don't really love that saying. It's just learning. It's just evolving.
Totally just evolving.
Tell us a little bit about what your business does exactly.
Yeah, of course. So we work with mostly female entrepreneurs to help them simplify and streamline their digital marketing and, you know, growing their business online. So we kind of do it in two ways. We either offer services where we do it for them, or we simply do it themselves. So one of the things that we're in the midst of launching is like called content workflow, which is how you can take one piece of content and turn it into like 25 pieces of content and amplify it on the internet. Yeah.
That's incredible. That's so valuable, you know, like, because that's a huge time saver, you know, but you're covering all the bases. That I love. Yeah. All right. And then I'll post it in the comments too. I have Jamie's website as well. I'm going to be checking it out. So make sure that all of you guys definitely check it out. And if you're like neck deep in business activities and you're starting to feel like completely overwhelmed because you're trying to do it all yourself, maybe you guys should think about reaching out to Jamie and seeing if her or somebody on her team can give you a hand with that. And because the idea is to work smarter, not harder. We're trying to get out of that employee mentality of having to be in a constant state of hustle. So definitely see how Jamie's company can help you guys get that, you know, streamlined and on autopilot and going and moving forward. We will definitely be checking out your website. I'm going to get these two little crazies wrangled.
So yeah, I'll share with you.
Oh, he's up.
He just woke up. Perfect timing. Mystery.
Perfect timing indeed. This one sort of smells bad too, so it is definitely perfect timing.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for having me. This was awesome.
Thank you. It was such a nice experience. I'm sorry for all the interruptions and all the crazy mom stuff. I'll definitely have to have you back when it's quiet.
All right. Have a good one.
Thanks. Talk to you soon.